this fuse, maxi fuse 30 amp. Is good. This fuse, PCM bat, 20 amp. Is good. Next fuse, fan 3 fuse, engine wiring harness junction block 2. That's over here. That would be this 25 amp fuse here. And it too has power. Next step. Next, we remove the fan relays. And we check and see if power is getting to the relays from the fuse. Power is getting to the relay from the fuse. So if the relay is working, the fans should work. How about 1 and 2 over here? Yep. Yep. So remember those terminals that we had power on, because the next step, we have to see if these things power up with the ignition switch on. Okay, with the ignition switch on. We have ignition power to fan relay 1. Fan relay 2, you'll notice, does not have ignition power. That's because this relay is used for low fan speed. It's actually correct. It only has one hot regardless. And number 3 is good. Relay jumpered, number 2 fan control relay in, which grounds the fans, and both fans are running. That's good. So we have low speed fans. Next we've got to check high speed fans. That's going to require, well, anyway, what we got here really tells us that the wiring to the fans is working. Both fans are working. The fan motors are obviously good, or they wouldn't be running. So there's no need to check really the wiring, which is the next step, so check all the wiring. What needs to be done now is a performance test.